What's up, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're going to be reacting to Elton John. I knew you were going to say that. I'm not saying that every single time.
Sir Elton John.
It's Elton John. It's Elton John. Unless what? Who calls
okay,
him
well,
sir?
I'll give you that. He was Elton John when he wrote this album. So, they call him that, man, dude, in his country.
Or is it like if your family you call him sir or something? Or is it
sir
your family
is like
you don't call him sir?
I don't know, man. It's a
I don't
prestigious
know that
title.
I don't know how the knight stuff works.
I think once they give it to you, it's
that's
like,
your name. It's in your name.
Yeah.
So on your birth certificate is like Sir Elton John.
I guess
now.
So. Yeah.
All right. Well, right now we're about to do Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting. This is off Goodbye Yellow Brick Road, the album, and we did two other ones off of this album too, and we like both of them.
And I think it's a I think it's a double album. So put in the suggestions more songs on this album because we're gonna keep exploring Elton John. We really like this album. All right, I've heard this song, of course, on the radio and stuff. Never really dialed into it like this. You've never heard it, right? What do you think about the title?
I might recognize it. I probably won't. I've never heard it. I don't think. What'd you say?
What do you think about the title?
So, I mean, it don't tell me nothing. Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting. I don't know, maybe some sort of fight club or something.
Can you imagine making that into a lyric in a song? How would you sing that, right?
I don't know. But Eminem has a song called Chloroseptic. How do you rap that word?
Okay, that's true. All right, let's go.
All right, here we go.
Chloroseptic. What do you think about this?
Man, it sounds good. I gotta say, compared to the other songs, it sounds very like upbeat and very like happy. Goodbye Yellow Brick Road is more of like a sad song, and I forgot the what
Rocket
Funeral
Man?
For a Friend.
Oh, Funeral for a Friend.
Funeral
yeah,
for
I think
a Friend. That one wasn't all the way sad, but it was. It had sad moments in it. This one is all the way just happy, pep, and like it's kind of a feel good song. I like it.
What do you think about how he's singing Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting? He's killing it the way he says it, isn't he?
Yeah, he put it in. That is the chorus. That long sentence is the whole chorus.
That's what I was saying. Imagine singing that, and then because I could hear it. Because once it's an earworm. This is a rock and roll song. This song right here,
it's a rock and roll song. But but Elton's over there on the piano though.
Elton John, man, does something.
Does he ever play the guitar?
I don't think he does, but he's got a good guitar player in that band right there. In fact, the very beginning of the song, if you could indulge me for a second, what is it? What seconds are we? How many seconds?
159.
All right, hold that. Go back and play the intro guitar thing. I want you to hear it, and I'm gonna tell you something.
Why?
Because I'm gonna. You'll see. Play it again, and I'm gonna tell you something. All right, hold on a second.
Yeah.
All right, get ready. All right.
Boy, I already know what you're doing.
Tell me. That don't sound like...
I know.
Who, start naming people. To me, it sounds like Kiss.
Van Halen.
Van Halen, for sure. That sounds like Panama.
It sounds just like Panama.
Boy,
just like Panama.
That's close to infringement right there.
I think if Van Halen is sued, they might win.
That's why I said this is rock and roll. It starts out rock. Man, listen. One thing I've learned on this reaction channel, like I said, they borrowed.
They'd be borrowing.
They borrowed heavily. You know
that sounds just like Van Halen, and that's Panama.
Thank you, bro. Thank you. I'm glad you indulged me and let me go back to it.
Even at the beginning, I was like, I recognize this. But then I did. And then after that, it was just like, okay, that's weird. I don't recognize it anymore.
Well, it definitely changes because Elton doesn't sing like anybody else. He's able to put so many words, like word count. He's got a high word count, man. He says a lot of things, and they're all good, and they're all interesting, but he says everything with so much passion. We got to see him do some live stuff because, dude, I think live, he's all sweating, and he's playing, and he's all into it, dude.
All right. Let's keep it going.
All right, 159. All right, hit it. This song is good. Go. Eddie Van Halen. Woo. You hear them drums? Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Yeah. Oh my god!
Goodness. That is a loud song. That's a lot going on.
That song is incredible. Is that his greatest hit? If I was like a person looking for a musician and I heard this song, I would be like, here's the check. You write it. Because you are incredible. This song is so incredible.
I mean, they put a lot into that song. I mean, they put... Man, I don't know who to thank. Like, the mixer or the guitarist, or I mean, because everything,
everybody
cause,
is on a like super because
everything is so loud and everything's, but I could hear everything. I had this thing cranked up. Hold up,
I heard look, all the instruments.
This is our mixer mixed. Right here.
Yeah.
Why this thing cranked up?
Me too.
I had it loud.
Mine went louder and louder the whole song, and then the last 2 minutes of the song.
It's just an all-out war with music.
And what's so funny at the end of the song is the drummer. He is killing it. And you know what?
And that's
my only slight critique is the drummer could have hit that cymbal like 50 more times. Because he cause, was like,
you right could have
went off. Zeppelin?
Right here.
Oh, Bonzo kills them cymbals.
It
deserved a crescendo of cymbals at the end. Elton kills it. Elton kills this song. His passion for music and singing is a level 10, and at the end, it's a 20. He goes up. I'm like, man, dude, you started out, it sounded like you were giving everything, and somehow he's like, I'm going to give more to this song. Buddy. I was like, Elton is killing it, man.
Man, he is so talented for this stuff he's doing.
He is, and it makes you feel good. And listen, if you were going to make a song,
where's his
something.
New bangers? He just stopped.
No, I mean, you know, he won Oscars and stuff. But, dude, if you're going to make a song about Saturday night, it's got to be a fire song. And this song brings the heat.
Well, I mean, it's Saturday right now. It's past 12 o'clock. It is Saturday.
Yeah. And this is going to go, hopefully this will go out today. It should go out on Saturday. Hey.
Yeah, for sure.
Look, for people who are old enough, and we have plenty of people on this channel who went to see Elton John, who bought this album when it came out. What happened in a club or in a place when this song came on? What did it do to it? And was it played in like a disco place? Where was this played? Because, or I'm sure this got
I'm
played
sure
at the roller skate rink.
Radio was number one, I would
yeah,
say.
Yeah, I know at radio, but I'd like to know how did the crowd react to it? Because you could like dance to this. You saw me hold my drink up. I mean, this song just brings it.
For I put my sunglasses on upside down. This was fire.
Which is very Elton John-ish. Because Elton John wore all kinds of crazy costumes and feathers. And like when he performed, you'll see whenever we see him live.
Look at his shoes.
I know. he does that times 10.
Them shoes is crazy.
Yeah.
He's got like an extra 4 inches from them shoes right there.
He does. Oh, somebody said, listen, they're not high heels. They're platform shoes. In the 70s, they were kind of in style. And even I mentioned Kiss. Even Kiss were wearing big old platform boots.
Yeah. All right. Well, that was Saturday Night's All Right for Fighting. We gonna
awesome.
Tell us what to react to next from Elton John in the comments. I guess off this album. I guess since we've done two off this one, let's just keep doing this album. Why not?
Yeah. This
tell
seems
us
like
what
an incredible
else.
Album.
Tell us what else to do off of Goodbye Yellow Brick Road. We gonna see you guys in the next video, and we're out. Peace.